Where's your entertainment, Aaron? Huh? I literally do not know how to turn on your radio.
Okay, go to...
Power?
No. The bottom, the southwestern corner, hit power.
Serious with that? Southwest?
Yeah. My baby.
Hey everybody, this is Carpool Conversations with Cole, Lab Edition. Hey everybody.
How's it going?
Who we got in the car with us today?
Candace can go first.
Candace?
I'm Candace Brooks.
Candace?
I'm the General Chemistry Manager of the State Environmental Laboratory.
Sweet.
And I am her employee. I'm Hunter Nelson.
Hunter?
I work in the lab and I do our database stuff. So.
Database stuff in a lab. Yep. Alright. Very good. Where are we going today?
I think we're going to... Hardware store?
Hardware store, picking up a battery.
Yep. My lawnmower just died, so.
That's really unfortunate.
Yeah. Got like halfway through the yard, so.
Hey, at least you're using a battery for your lawnmower, I guess.
Very good. What does the lab actually do?
Everything.
Everything. Like solving crimes and...
Yeah, actually. We test a lot of drinking water, wastewater, surface water.
Okay.
For... environmental health, public health.
Awesome. Okay, okay.
So that's our big thing is we do a lot of water testing.
Water testing.
So, and like Hunter said, we have a lot of different customers, a different wide variety of customers. So he referred to some of our public water supply systems. So these are people that drink maybe city water, but you're, they still have to test their water to make sure it's okay for people to drink. We also do quite a bit of private customers, so people that are on wells can actually get their water tested too through the State Environmental Laboratory and we'll run those analysis for them.
I could knock out some Elsa from Frozen.
Let it go!
Let it go!
Yeah, my voice is terrible.
That was solid. I legit bought Frozen before I had kids. We've had a little bit of rain, I don't know if you've noticed, in the last like couple of months. So a little bit of water came down.
A few feet.
People have had their wells flooded, right?
Sure, absolutely.
Do you guys do sampling for that? Like, what does that look like?
Yeah.
So,
go for it.
Okay, so what we're testing is for the wells that are flooded. Mm-hmm. When you bring in your sample, you'll have like a set of criteria you already have to meet. It's like disinfection. You have to have the wait period. But I think we're just doing micro testing on that. So. Presence, absence of total coliform or E. coli bacteria.
All right.
And then I think the deadline is on that, the 15th of
August?
Yep, August
15th. So. And so people that their wells were completely submerged, we recommend that they disinfect their well, which means they actually pour chlorine bleach down their well to disinfect, and they let it, 24 hours, they kind of let it sit in the lines and stuff, let it disinfect, and then you pull a sample, and your first test is actually free right now.
Oh!
So we're offering that as a free service, so we're really trying to promote that. It's always a good idea in general to get your well tested, like once a year, but especially if your well has been submerged underwater to make sure that it's safe to drink.
I was attacked by a goose in the field.
Total coliform doesn't necessarily mean poo water.
Okay.
Because coliforms are pretty much everywhere. They're in the dirt, on the grass, on your hands.
Yeah.
Oh.
In your hair, all over this car, you know.
I don't have to worry about that. It's going away.
So the E. coli is what we kind of equate to like a fecal contamination.
Okay. So what are some of the risks, like if my well is submerged, what could like happen if I don't get it tested and end up with...
You could also get the runs.
Yeah.
Okay.
So it's very cyclic.
Yeah. You could get sick.
You can get sick.
Go DEQ and give us some good stuff.
Yeah.
My dog's a killer.
We do radiochemistry. So uranium and radium 226 and stuff like that.
We're trying to avoid like Chernobyl kind of stuff.
Yeah.
Okay.
For sure.
So do you have your CSI crime lab in there too? Like, do you guys do like criminal stuff or like...
That's classified.
Kick open the door.
It's classified.
Classified.
So we actually
really
do fight
some...
crime.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, we fight crime.
Legit, yeah.
Should have brought my cape.
Yeah. Let's do some get to know yous. We're going to do some rapid fire. All right. Rapid fire! All right. So I say two things. You say the first one that comes to your mind. Cool. Yeah. Don't need an explanation if you want to. You can, but... 90210 or Saved by the Bell?
90210.
Saved by the Bell.
All right. ER, Grey's Anatomy.
ER. George Clooney.
I gotta go ER. George
instantly.
Clooney.
All right. Oh, what about McDreamy and McSteamy?
I know. Patrick Dempsey. Okay, Grey's Anatomy.
All right. All right.
One and one.
One. Friends or Seinfeld? Oh, the hardest one of the day.
Friends.
Seinfeld.
Okay. All right. Will and Grace or Roseanne?
Will and Grace.
Will and Grace.
100%.
Megan Mullally. You gotta support our Oklahoma folks.
Very good.
Yeah.
All right. So a really tough one. Parks and Rec or The Office?
You can't ask that question.
That's not fair.
No, it's not fair.
Go, Hunter.
Parks and Rec.
Parks and Rec, all right.
I'm gonna go Parks and Rec, too. For Nick Offerman?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
He's married to Megan Mullally.
Oklahoma. Yes.
Oklahoma all the way.
All right. So for a vitally important one, since it's summer, snow cone or ice cream?
Ice cream.
Ice cream.
What kind of flavor?
Yes.
Yes, all right. Any of the above?
I'm a very vanilla person.
Vanilla? All right.
Vanilla.
I'll take it. All right. So now that we've approached some TV shows, what is your favorite one of all time?
Game of Thrones.
Game of Thrones?
Except for the last season.
Yeah. Did you like the ending?
Not at all. It was lame.
Yeah.
I tend to kind of like the ones that I'm watching right now. It's my favorite one. So I'm actually watching one right now called Yellowstone.
Right to my heart. Yes.
It's really good.
It is awesome.
It almost makes me want to be a cowboy.
Yes.
But not quite.
Oh, no. That's the cool part is that...
Says the girl who doesn't even want to camp.
You get it? Oh, well.
I mean, I'm scared of the dark.
Camping and cowboy are way different things.
Oh,
I'm not a camper,
definitely.
But I moonlight as a cowboy sometimes.
I mean, I could maybe cowboy if I had a helicopter.
Well, I mean, that makes everything worth doing, right?
Sounds a little bit better.
Yeah. I mean, drop me in a helicopter and let me drive around to my ranch.
I know.
Yeah, sign me up for that.
Yeah. What's your... Kevin Costner.
Yeah, I mean, yeah. That just makes life worth living.
Yeah.
All right, what's your favorite summer activity? Other than cruising around with Carpool Conversations.
This is pretty enjoyable, actually.
Yeah?
Going to the lake.
Lake?
Yep.
Yeah? I like the lake too. We
fish, boat.
Are you like an Oklahoma lake guy? Like you venturing out a little bit to other lakes?
I mean, Eufaula is my main lake.
Masters or Dr.
Oh!
I think we're back. We're back. Where'd you guys go to high school?
Mustang?
Yeah.
I actually went to Edmond Memorial High School.
All right. So do we have any like high school fight songs?
Edmond Bulldogs, fight. I don't remember.
Go team. Hey, that was close. All right. Well, hey, we just pulled up to our hardware store. Catch you guys later. It looks like it was a quite successful hardware store trip.
Oh, yeah.
What'd you get?
Got my battery. Got this welcome sign. It spoke to me. It said, welcome.
All right, Hunter, where'd you go?
Oklahoma State.
Yes!
Go
finally!
Folks.
All right.
Yes.
It took
No,
get out of here with that, boomer. You're gonna go to the museum of like three-toed cats or something like that, or five-toed cats in Key West. So, I hear we've got some random facts. Are you a random fact person?
I just Googled some stuff.
Googled some stuff, okay.
Because she wasn't prepared at all for this.
But did you know?
Did I know? Okay.
That 70% of the human brain is made up of water.
I did not know that.
Hunter, did you know that?
Because you told me about 20
Hey, your light's
ago.
On up there.
Oh, hey.
I think it was up. I don't know.
Oh, it's on purpose.
It's
okay.
My lighting.
Sorry.
It's mood lighting.
I didn't mean to. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to ruin that. I'm sorry. Okay. Did you know?
I did not know why that light was on.
Well, I tried to help, but...
Dolly and I back here, we need the best lighting.
Did you know that during the Middle Ages, beer was consumed more than water?
Those are
because
my
the alcohol was safer to drink. Did you know that your bones consist of 31% water?
What? 31%?
Yeah.
I thought it was all like... calcium and stuff. That's,
I don't know. That's
actually impressive.
I know.
Did not know that. There's a carrier pigeons went extinct during one of the world wars because they used them carrier pigeons and people shot them down.
Really?
For sure. Yeah.
So sad.
I know, but.
Shot down in line of duty.
Yep.
I wonder if they had like purple hearts for the pigeons that made it.
They didn't. That's the idea. They're extinct. I really wish they did, but I think it was an unfortunate casualty.
They didn't have any pigeon rehabilitation.
No, I don't think there was. Different time.
So sad.
It really is. I'm sorry.
All those little uniforms. Oh.
Pigeon uniforms. I've learned so much about the lab today. Well, guys, we are officially back. Thank you so much for carpooling with me today.
Thanks for driving.
And yeah. This has been Carpool Conversations with Colt.